As you probably already know, support for Windows 10 has ended, which means it no longer gets security updates. This may not be a big deal for you, and neither is it for me on most of my computers, but I do want a supported operating system on my main machine. I would upgrade to Windows 11. It's not too bad, when it doesn't literally write the word homicide on your screen. But even though my PC does have TPM 2.0, its CPU isn't new enough to satisfy the multi-billion dollar corporation. So I'll have to consider a different solution, such as a Linux distribution, or an enterprise long-term support version of Windows. It is possible to bypass the Windows 11 requirements and install it on many older computers, but that's only a temporary victory, as I'll explain later. An obvious solution, of course, is to ditch your perfectly good machine and buy a newer one compatible with Windows 11. That's what I ended up doing a few weeks ago. Here it is. This is the Valve Steam Deck. But wait, isn't this a video game console running a Linux distribution called SteamOS? Yes, but this is actually a standard x86 IBM PC compatible computer at heart, which is the reason I bought it. Oh, and it was on sale too. I wouldn't have paid full price for it. I didn't get this handheld machine specifically for Windows, but when I dual booted SteamOS with it, I was pleased to discover it meets all official Windows 11 requirements. Even the AMD custom CPU. Despite the surprise, the Steam Deck will not replace my ThinkPad T440S, which I enrolled in the Windows 10 extended security updates, while I continue experimenting with options to stay supported beyond October 2026. Here we are in October 2025. Even if you're watching this video later, it doesn't matter. Patch Tuesday has arrived, which is the second Tuesday of the month, and mainstream Windows 10 support ended. Well, Windows 11 versions 23H2 and newer get an average monthly security update. Years ago, I did a Windows 10 update race video. Now that I have two Windows 11 computers, I decided to do it again. The other Windows 11 computer I have here is a 2009 MacBook Pro, on which I installed Windows 11 about 2 years ago, and I've still got that installation now, even though I rarely use it. This 2009 Mac is slow compared to the Steam Deck that was introduced in 2022. But let's compare installation time anyway. The Steam Deck here actually has a couple more updates, which is why it estimates a longer update time. Let's restart them now. The newer computer obviously finished first, but not by that much. That extra update it had required an additional restart. Now let's make sure they're actually updated. The Steam Deck is, and here's a surprise, we're offered version 25H2. Currently I have 24H2 installed, whose support ends in November 2026. 25H2 will last an extra year. If you ignore this update, it will be automatically installed in the coming months, ensuring you keep a supported OS. But how about the MacBook? It doesn't matter how old it is, because all Macs don't officially support Windows 11 due to their lack of TPM 2.0. This one is running version 23H2, whose support ends in November 2025, merely 1 month after Windows 10. And if you have Windows 11 versions 22H2 or older, you've been out of support for a longer time, actually less safe than Windows 10. Surely it should update to 24H2 or newer, right? But nope, we get nothing from Windows Update, even though it's had those monthly security updates. That's the temporary victory I was referring to. That's the fatal flaw about installing Windows 11 on unsupported hardware. Just because you've bypassed the requirements doesn't mean you're up to date. It's not your fault, of course, it's Microsoft's, for having these absurd official requirements. But be aware of this. Unless you have the wherewithal to update Windows 11 manually every single year to version 24H2, 25H2, and so on, you will have an unsafe machine on the internet. And if your computer is older than circa 2010, like this Core 2 Duo machine here, even updating manually won't work, as Windows 11 version 24H2 and newer will not boot if your processor lacks the SSE 4.2 features, and you can't patch the system files, like for Windows 8 and its NX requirement, At least not yet. The Core 2 Duo CPU is getting long in the tooth, but it's not totally obsolete just because of this. Chrome OS and most updated Linux distros still run fine, if you've got a solid state drive. If you must stick with Windows and you don't care about security updates, might as well stick with an older version. On my Mac, I installed 11 just as an experiment, but 7 or 10 would perform a lot better on it. Anyway, there's not much else to this little video. I'm still learning the Steam Deck, which is an interesting computer for the not-so-high price I paid. I use the SteamOS desktop mode more than its gaming mode or Windows. Got no problems with a few video games I seldom play. I'm even using this device to record the voiceover. It has a really good quality stereo microphone. And edit this video with peripherals attached to a USB Type-C dock. Thank you for watching.